الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وصلى الله على سيدنا حبيبنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي آمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran and presents for us, as he often does, to consider something and to reflect upon something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Saff, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَلْ أَدُلَّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ومساكن طيبات في جنات عدن ذلك الفوز العظيم وأخرى تحبونها نصر من الله وفتح قريب. And when we examine this verse, brothers and sisters, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost begins by saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. That is to say, he is referring to a particular audience or a recipient of this verse. And that is those who have faith, those who believe. And when, according to the commentators, Ibn Abbas, most famously he says, radiallahu anhu, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins or says something in the Quran, beginning with يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, pay attention. Pay close attention, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is either asking or demanding something of you, or He is preventing something from you, or asking you to not do something, not engage in something. And here in particular, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting the believers, هَلْ أَدُلَّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting the believers to a transaction, a tijara. A tijara, unlike any other transaction, because it will save you from a grievous or a severe punishment. Now, when we look at tijara, or transactional matters, or trade, commerce, one, we have to pay attention and be reminded of the initial recipients of this message. That largely the community that was present were either themselves directly or indirectly involved in some sort of a trade or commerce. It was not uncommon for the community at the time to be merchants, to be involved in transaction, commercial enterprise. But that's not just a historical point of reference. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala understands human nature. And at the basis of human nature is that we seek reward or benefit in that which we do. That's just human nature, to seek something of value or benefit. If I'm going to put forth effort, if I'm going to do something, then I want something mutually, I want something that is of benefit back to me. And this may seem rather selfish, but it's human nature. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala understands that we are human beings and we have this drive, this need to find benefit and value in that which we do. And is not passing a value judgment about that particular concept of seeking value or benefit. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is framing this like a commercial transaction. And when we look at a commercial transaction, we find that a commercial transaction, if you go and you buy something, from someone, from a merchant. You will oftentimes give that person money, and in exchange for money, you get goods or services. That's a basic transaction, a basic commercial transaction. And so both parties mutually benefit. So you have party A, who is paying something, money in this case, and in response or in return, party B is handing over goods or services. Both parties benefit. Both parties give up something, but in return, they get something. And so that's a basic human commercial transaction. And that is what tijara is. It is this commercial transaction between parties. But this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we are talking about. And when Allah, the Lord and sustainer and ruler of humanity and the king of the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, presents for us a transaction, it is going to be a very special transaction. And so what makes this tijara unique? What makes this commercial transaction unlike any other? And let's look at that. So the first party, type party A here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting that party or that individual and saying, هَلْ أَدُلَّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. That party A, what is demanded of that first party, is that first and foremost, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now what's interesting is, as I said, at the very outset, at the very beginning of the verse, Allah is addressing who? The believers. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. So you would assume that it's almost a foregone conclusion that the person that is being invited here to this transaction is a believer. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reinforcing. That's what's being employed here, is reinforcing the idea that in order to be a party of this transaction, they must believe in Allah and His Messenger. Have faith. Iman. Have iman in Allah and in His Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then it continues. وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. That they strive, that they engage in jihad with their wealth, material possessions, and with their person, their selves. Now what's interesting, brothers and sisters, is when we look and we examine the word jihad, we know that at its very root, the word jihad means to engage in a struggle. That is to say that it is going to be a burden. It is going to be challenging. But nonetheless, we are asked to engage in this challenge, to participate, to give it our all with regards to being a party of this transaction. And we know that each and every one of us, when we look at our own lives, we know that each and every one of us has our own individual struggles. What I struggle with may not be something that you struggle with. What I am afflicted with may not be something that is an affliction for you. What is a burden to me may not be a burden to you. It is an individually based assessment. It is not, as they say, it is not objective, but rather it is subjective. Each and every one of us has our own deficiencies. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling upon us as individuals, if we wish to participate in this very important transaction, is that we persevere, is that we struggle to overcome those deficiencies. And so what it asks us first and foremost is to examine what it is that you struggle with. What is it that is a challenge to you? And then we can begin to look at what is a challenge and what is of a struggle for us as a community or on a communal level. But first and foremost, this is calling upon us individually to take an assessment of what it is that we struggle with. And to then, if we wish to be a participant in this very important transaction, is to overcome that struggle, is to persevere against what it is that is deficient in ourselves individually. And we find ourselves in the days after Ramadan, a month in which we are called upon to take an assessment of where we are. Because Ramadan serves as that yearly barometer, as that yearly opportunity where we can gauge ourselves. Where am I with regards to my relationship with Allah? Where am I as an individual? Me. Where am I as a person in with regards to my relationship with my Lord, with His religion, with His book, and with His commandments? And so that Ramadan that served as a barometer, as an opportunity for us to gauge and measure ourselves, we now are weeks after the month of Ramadan, afforded an opportunity to kind of know where we stand. We know what we struggled with in Ramadan. We know what posed as a challenge for us to overcome our appetites, regardless of what those appetites are. And so we stand equipped at this moment in time to assess ourselves, to see where we are. And so I call upon each and every one of us to take inventory of where you are with regards to what it is that you struggle with, that poses a challenge to you, and that if you wish to participate in this transaction that is unlike any other transaction, then take an assessment of who you are and where you are, and then struggle and persevere against it. And remarkably enough, Ramadan presented not only an opportunity for us to measure ourselves, to gauge ourselves, but also gave us the tools with which we can overcome our deficiencies. Fasting, prayer, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being grateful with little, being satisfied, being satiated with little. Those are the tools. Those are what we need to engage in this struggle. And interestingly enough, brothers and sisters, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the revelation of fasting was revealed to that community, the commandment that directly followed after that command of fasting was the command of jihad. There was no commandment in between fasting and jihad, because it was understood that fasting would give us the wherewithal, the ability to struggle, the ability to engage in that mujahidah, in that struggle and that perseverance that we needed to endure the struggle. وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. That is better for you. إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. If only that you knew. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues. And this is what makes this transaction unique and different than any other transaction. Because this is a transaction that is not mutually beneficial to both parties. This is a transaction that only one party benefits, and that is us. That is the believers that are being called upon, being invited to this transaction. Allah is in no need of our prayers, of our faith in Him, of our fasting, of our charity, of our jihad, of our struggle. Allah doesn't need it. Allah is sufficient without it. Allah is not dependent upon this transaction, is not going to benefit from this transaction. The only party here that benefits is party A, you and I, who engage in this transaction, who participate in this tijara. We benefit. Because then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues enumerating the benefits of this transaction to party A, to you and me. And that is, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. That Allah will forgive us of our sins. He will forgive us of our sins and enter us into paradise, beneath which rivers flow. And we will dwell in that beautiful abode of paradise for the hereafter, for the afterlife, everlasting abode in that afterlife. That is everlasting, never-ending benefit of His paradise. وَأُخْرَى تُحِبُّونَهَا. And then He gives us more, as if forgiveness of our sins being entered into the bliss of paradise, of His presence, of all of His reward and benefit wasn't enough. وَأُخْرَى تُحِبُّونَهَا. And something more that you desire, that you crave, that you love. And that is نَصْرٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَتْحٌ قَلِيمٌ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That He gives us the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Nasr of Allah is given to this party who participates in this very important hijab. And all we are called upon to do, to engage in this transaction, is to believe, is to have the sanctuary of faith, the yaqeen of faith, and to give it our all, to do our best, to do our best. That is all that is being demanded of us, is to just simply do our best to struggle with those things that challenge us, those struggles that we face individually, and yes, as a community. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to reward us as part of this very important transaction that we are being called and invited to. And so I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters, gives us the ability to think about this transaction, to be a party of this beautiful transaction, to benefit from all that this transaction has within it, and to benefit from it, both ourselves individually and collectively. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إسرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقيموا الصلاة.